So yesterday afternoon, Wanheng Menayothin, the WBC minimum weight champion, successfully defended his title, notching himself up to 49-0 with 17 knockouts with a successful defense of his title against former WBO strawweight champion, 105-pound champion, Tatsuya Fukuhara. And what was a really good fight. I thought it was actually really competitive between the two of them. Definitely one of the closer fights that Wanheng has had. He's had a couple of, you know, relatively close fights or you know, competitive fights at the very least. Saul Juarez being one of them most particularly. But this one, in certain ways, was even more so than that. Fukuhara was giving Wanheng a lot of trouble early on, I think, with his reach, especially. You know, Fukuhara has had a pretty good height and reach advantage in there. 2.5, maybe even 3 inches of height, and you know, possibly around the same in terms of reach as well. He was a southpaw fighting against Wanheng as an orthodox fighter, and you know, there was some head clashes a little bit here and there. But early on, Fukuhara, I think, was giving him a little bit of trouble with the distance. Fukuhara is a fighter that is able to fight pretty much at any distance, inside, outside, mid range, relatively well. Although he tends to go to the body quite a bit, and I think that somewhat kind of takes away from scoring for him. And I think, incidentally, it is part of the reason why he lost his title to Ryuri Yamanaka. Yamanaka focused a little bit more to the head, and I think the judges wound up scoring that accordingly for him, favoring him more so on the cards than Fukuhara. I think a lot of the same thing happened here between Wanheng and Fukuhara, because I wasn't able to actually get the score totals. But judging by the way that the WBC's open scoring had it after 4 rounds and after 8 rounds, it seemed like Wanheng won relatively clearly. As a matter of fact, actually, it looks like they do actually have the scores updated on BoxRec finally. I checked them yesterday. They hadn't been updated yet. But it looks like Wanheng won by the margins 116-112, 117-113, and 118-110, all for him. Personally, I thought it was actually a very close fight. I thought it, you know, it could have been a draw, or... personally, I scored it 7 rounds to 5 for Wanheng. I basically just had him kind of edging it out, especially in the later rounds. Once it got to the championship rounds, I thought is where Wanheng managed to kind of salvage it, because Fukuhara was pretty much there neck and neck with him throughout the early and the mid rounds, especially. He was giving him a lot of trouble just with this high volume, the constant body work, the fact that, I mean, he was constantly throwing a lot of the head movement, especially early on, was giving Wanheng a lot of trouble. Wanheng is the guy, type of guy that, you know, once he gets into a rhythm, he does really good. He tends to start a little bit slowly, especially in the first round. But he was landing the right hand repeatedly down the stretch, pretty much the last 4 rounds. And that's where he was able to, I guess, control the action and be able to make sure to keep himself up on the cards. But I think even just if you look at the way that the corners were reacting in the midst of the fight, like you could see Fukuhara's corner repeatedly, like, you know, egging him on to, like, you know, keep going at him, because he was having quite a bit of success throughout the fight, especially on the inside, which is someplace where you wouldn't necessarily expect it as much, being that he was the taller fighter. And it seemed like it'd be more Wenheng's game to try and cut the distance and be able to kind of sharp shoot with the shorter, choppier shots on the inside. But it turned out that, you know, Wanheng was actually able to get a pretty good bead of range, at the mid range with Fukuhara. And once he was able to get kind of full extension on the right hand, especially, and he actually landed quite a few jabs as well, is where Wanheng managed to actually shine. But I mean, there's a reason why in the past I've rated Wanheng as the best, you know, strawweight in the world. You know, I would kind of go back and forth between him and Jose Argumedo back when Argumedo was the champion, just before he got dethroned by Hiroto Kiyoguchi. Wanheng, hey, he showed and proved it here against Fukuhara, and I think this was a kind of a good measuring stick fight too, considering the fact that Fukuhara only lost a very close fight and also won a close fight. You know, he won a close fight against Moises Calleros to win the WBO title to begin with, and then he lost a very close fight against Ryu Yamanaka. So I mean, just comparing this performance to Yamanaka's performance, I think, you know, it speaks well for Wanheng. You know, he's to me, I think, been a little bit more consistent than most of the recent 105-pound title holders as it stands. But solid win for Wanheng. You know, I think he's starting to get a little bit more coverage now because of the fact that, you know, he is 49-0. He managed to tie the Floyd Mayweather and Rocky Marciano record of having the most wins without a blemish on your record while being a reigning world champion. And incidentally, even though, you know, Mayweather stands at 50-0 now, you know, he wasn't a title holder against Conor McGregor, unless you want to count maybe the being lineal welterweight champion. I guess in that way you could count that for him having broken the record of being, you know, having the most wins without a loss or a draw in being a world champion level fighter. But it's very likely that Wanheng could actually surpass that record in the next year. He's a very active fighter. This was actually his fifth fight of 2017. So, you know, he's very active, very, very active, you know. And not all of his fights have been world title defenses either. You know, he's had a couple of non-title defenses here and there. You know, they keep you real active in Thailand if you want to be. So he's definitely kept himself really active. I'd really like to see him a little bit more internationally. You know, if they could get him stateside, especially with somebody like, say, like Srisar Ketsarangvisai's emergence as a bit more of like an international worldwide star with the wins over Roman Gonzalez. You know, there's definitely an opening there for Wanheng to potentially capitalize on it beyond, you know, the borders of Thailand and everything, even though I don't think shares any kind of promotional interests with Srisar Ket, because from what I've seen, they're of like different camps. I'm clued in to a certain degree with the Thai boxing scene, but not as much with regards to the promotional interests and like who controls what. I just know that like there's different camps, and I know that Wanheng specifically is of a different camp from Srisar Ket. He's actually of a rival camp. A lot of times you can kind of tell by the color of the trunks, you know, when like Srisar Ket, for instance, along with the likes of of the other fighter whose name I'm blanking on right now, Suryang Sorongvisai, a couple other fighters, like they'll have the yellow and red emblazoned trunks, you know, sponsored by M150. Wanheng Menayothin has the green and blue trunks, you know, with the chief sponsor is a different different promoting interest. But you know, he's managed to come this far, has had a number of title defenses now, and doesn't look like his train is slowing up anytime soon. So it'll be interesting to see how it goes further along. You know, I'd definitely like to see some unifications happen. I know that him and Knockout Soupy Freshmart, the WBA champion, are promoted by the same people, but the only thing is you don't see too many Thai unifications between two Thai fighters unless, you know, unless they were to collect all the belts. You know, if Wanheng were to fight somebody like Ryu Yamanaka and unify that belt, and then say like Knockout CP Freshman were to fight Hiroto Kiyoguchi and unify that belt, then I'd imagine then the winners might fight each other. But up until then, it might be a little bit, it won't be quite as fierce, I think, as like say 108 pounds is now, with the talks of Tanaka possibly unifying three of the belts now with whoever wins between Taguchi and Melindo's unification for the WBA and the IBF. And then, you know, you also have Kenshiro out there with the WBC belt, and there's a good chance that he could get into the mix as well, and we might have an undisputed 108 pound champion soon. Hopefully something similar comes about for the 105 pound division, because I think fans definitely deserve to see some of these fights happen. A lot of good fights there to be had, and a lot of good fights that have happened already. But I think there's just that next step up where it's like you're truly seeing elite versus, you know, the true cream of the crop, top of the top, taking on each other. You know, and I definitely like to see that from the likes of Wanheng Menayothin, Naka Tsipi Freshmart, Ryu Yamanaka, Hiroto Kiyoguchi, Jose Romero, Moises Calleros, etc. You know, all these guys, I think, need to be fighting each other for sure. You know, they have been to a certain degree, but I'd definitely like to see the titles actually be unified, as opposed to, you know, guys that have recently been deposed of their title then fighting for one of the other titles, you know, even though that's, I guess, kind of the second best of all the options out there. But that's going to do it for this one. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.